In this video, we're continuing on with the second page of the Congruence and Triangles worksheet, picking up where we left off with number 9. Our directions are to write a statement that indicates that the triangles in each pair are congruent. In number 9, I'm going to start by saying triangle PQR. That's going to be congruent to triangle. Both of them share points P and Q. However, this is not a reflection. So as opposed to starting with P and saying triangle PQD, I'm going to start with Q and say triangle QPD. So triangle PQR is congruent to triangle QPD. Note that this is because angle P is congruent to angle Q. So I'm starting with writing P, so my first letter of my other triangle will be Q. Then my second letter in this triangle is Q, but Q in this triangle is congruent to angle P in this triangle. So my next angle will be P, and then R is congruent to D. So my last letter when labeling is R and D. Let's move on to number 10. In number 10, I'm going to start with triangle RST. That triangle is congruent to triangle, well, R is congruent to angle S. So where R is first in this triangle, S is going to be first in this triangle. Angle S in this triangle is congruent with angle R in the next triangle. So R is my second letter. And then where T is my last letter in this triangle, that T is congruent with I. So I have that triangle RST is congruent to triangle SRI. In number 11, I'll start with triangle VWX. That's going to be congruent to, let's look at the sides. VW has one tick mark and WX has two tick marks. So I'm going to start with the side with one tick mark and continue on to the side with two tick marks, labeling appropriately. So here is my side with one tick mark, and there is my side with two tick marks. So CD is congruent to VW, and WX is congruent to DE. So I have triangle VWX congruent to triangle CDE. And if you want to double check with angles, angle V is congruent to angle C, angle W is congruent to angle D, and angle X is congruent to angle E. Let's move on to number 12. In number 12, again, I'll label using the sides. So we have side ST congruent to this side, and we have side TU congruent to this side. Because ST has one tick mark, CD has one tick mark, TU has two tick marks, and DE has tick marks. So keeping the letters in order, so since T is in the middle here, D will be in the middle as well. So I have triangle STU is congruent to triangle CDE. So just remember, when labeling triangles, you must keep the labeling in order that's associated with the congruence. So angle S congruent to angle C, S and C are the first letters listed. Angle T congruent to angle D, T and D are the second letters listed. And then angle U is congruent to angle E. Those are the last letters listed. Let's move on to our next set of directions. For numbers 13 through 16, we are to mark the angles and sides of each pair of triangles to indicate that they are congruent. So for number 13, it says triangle BDC is congruent to triangle MLK. Our first letters are B and M, so those angles are congruent. So B is congruent to M. Our second letters, D and L, those angles will be congruent. So D is congruent to L. And I like to show congruency in angles with tick marks. So I will do a combination of both. And lastly, C is congruent to angle K. So C and K. So next, segment BD will be congruent to segment ML. So one tick mark on BD and one tick mark on ML. Segment DC will be congruent to segment LK. Two tick marks on DC, two tick marks on LK. And then lastly, BC will be congruent to MK. Three tick marks on BC, three tick marks on MK. So all my sides and angles are appropriately marked. Let's move on to number 14. And number 14, angle G is congruent to angle L. Angle F is congruent to angle K. And angle E is congruent to angle M. And in this problem, when marking my angles, I'm just using the tick mark method. Either way, whether you use tick marks or if you indicated with three lines, either way is fine, just as long as you keep it consistent within the problem. So now let's mark our sides, and I'm going to mark them based on the angles. So since G is congruent to L and F is congruent to K, from G to F, that's going to be congruent, and from L to K, that's going to be congruent. Then I'm going to move from my angle with two tick marks to my angle with three tick marks. So FE is congruent to KM. And then from my angle with three tick marks to my angle with one tick mark, I will have three tick marks on that segment. And that's my solution in number 14. In number 15, angle M is congruent to angle S. K is congruent to T. And L is congruent to L. Next, I'll label my sides. MK is congruent to ST. KL is congruent to TL. And ML is congruent to SL. And that's my solution in number 15. In number 16, triangle HIJ is congruent to triangle JTS. So first I'll mark H, then I'll mark I with two tick marks, and then J with three. So in this triangle, I'll mark J with one tick mark, T with two tick marks, and S with three tick marks. So from H to I, that's going to be one tick mark, I to J will be two tick marks, and HJ will be three. JT will be one tick mark, TS will be two tick marks, JS will be three tick marks. I'll start with my sides. Side CD is congruent to side CD, one tick mark. Segment DB is congruent to segment DL. So DB is congruent to DL. And lastly, segment CB is congruent to segment CL. So CB gets three tick marks and CL gets three tick marks. Next, I'll do my angle. C and C are congruent. D and D are congruent. And B and L are congruent. And lastly, number 18. However, before I walk you through the answer to this, please remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated, and let me know that you're finding this helpful. So, number 18, we have triangle JIK congruent to triangle JCD. Angle J is congruent to angle J. Angle I is congruent to angle C. And that leaves me with D and K being congruent. Next, side JI or segment JI is congruent to segment JC. So JI is congruent to segment JC. Segment IK is congruent to segment CD. Segment IK congruent to segment CD. And then my last sides are also congruent. So JK is congruent to JD. And with that answer, we wrap up our triangles and congruence worksheet. Hopefully, you've already clicked that subscribe button. But if you haven't, here's a friendly reminder to go ahead and do that. Also, if you have any questions, leave it in the comment section below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Or just go ahead and leave me a note letting me know that you found this video helpful.